Okay guys, back here once again at the Jericho Turnpike traffic lights, and got a new update video for you. As you can see, the new lights are up. They have a brand new no turn sign there, so they're not going to move the old one over, they're just going to replace it completely. And as you can see, this set is going to have those back plates I told you about. You can see the yellow reflective tape behind it. And I did see these lights before they shrouded them, so I can tell you that the new lights will have the hold on. I left the truck up by there. The new lights will have the straight through arrows for this direction, so that's kind of cool. There is one issue I have with these back plates, though. I never really explained to you what it was, but this is basically what it is. It's like, the problem with them is, you know, I'm not concerned about the span not handling them because, you know, it handled Hurricane Irene and Hurricane Sandy, but the problem is, you know, they do increase wind load on the lights, as you know, and as well as, do you see that? Do you see the tape on there, the yellow reflective tape? On several sets I've seen go up with the with these back plates installed, within like a month or 2 months, the tape starts coming off, and then the workers have to put some kind of, I guess, adhesive or glue on it to put it back on. And I mean, that's not the biggest problem, but I don't know if the manufacturer knows about that, or maybe like my friend Blade Zero said, maybe the manufacturer knows about it and he's trying to cut corners, which really wouldn't surprise me, because you know how people are nowadays with building stuff correctly. Well, most stuff, but you know, you get what I mean. And as you can tell, that new sign is indeed on the same cable as the lights, so there won't be an upper cable like I thought there would be. But as you can see, that second cable is still right there, so I'm thinking maybe that's the set's lower cable, and maybe they just put it up there for the time being, just so it's, you know, just so it's there and, you know, kind of out of the way or whatever. So, I don't know. I mean, instead of constantly guessing about it, we'll just figure out what happens when the new set gets activated, and we'll see where it goes from there. And I don't think there's going to be any major changes to this set. It's still going to function exactly the same way as it does now. It's going to have these two directions go, and then have the side street go, and then it's going to just repeat that cycle. That's basically how it's going to go. So, not much else with this set, I guess. We'll go down to the second set there in a minute, and there's something like kind of unusual about it, just the way it's set up. But here's this set for you, and we'll go to the next one in just a second, so hang on. Okay guys, and now we're here over at the second set, and once again, you can see everything's up. The lights, most of the back plates are up right now. Maybe the side street won't have them, but as you can see, there's that cluster turn signal, so it's now confirmed that there will be a protected left turn for that left lane, which left turn lane rather, which I'm really happy to see. And there's the two new lights for this direction over here. But something's kind of, what's confusing me about this set, like I mentioned to you before, is remember how I told you last time that one light is the only one for this street right here? Well, looking at this set currently, there is no light for that direction now. I mean, I know it's not finished, it's not activated yet, and there is a light on the other side of the cluster turn signal, but, I mean, I can't tell if it's a left turn signal or not, because it's, you know, it's all covered, and I can't tell what the lenses look like, but, it looks like they're setting up some priority receivers by those two lights right there. It's kind of a wire mess right now, but maybe you can sort of see it, that's kind of what they're setting up right now. And there's those back plates again. The lower cable currently isn't installed right now, but it eventually will be once they activate it. That's usually the last step that they do for these light sets. So yeah, I mean, I don't exactly know what they're planning for that side street over here, because there's literally no light facing for that direction. So I don't know. I mean, I should probably stop guessing until they activate the set, right? I mean, it makes the most sense. Like again, maybe they didn't put something up yet or whatever. And it just, these lights are definitely a lot higher than the old ones are, including the previous set. Maybe they did that on purpose, maybe it's like regulations or something, I'm not sure. Could be for trucks or whatever. But, and like I said, it's possible the side street may not have any back plates. They've done that on a couple of sets. Again, why they do that, I have no idea. So, I mean, just probably how they do some of the sets. But everything looks good, and I'm just, you know, once again, happy that Suffolk County's doing all the span sets. You know, I love those. And give me a shot over there, the truck goes by. And I guess not much else to say, just here's your video on it, and a confusing video since I don't know exactly what's going on with that one side street, but everything looks good. Every lane's going to have a light now, which as some of you may know, is I think a requirement for certain types of intersections now. I think like each lane, or at least every straight through lane, has to have a light for it. I know that's, I know someone pointed it out to me, and I think I read about it somewhere in, you know, boy, that wasn't very good. And I think someone read about it in like a website for the rules and regulations of lights or something. So I guess that's basically it for this. I mean, I'll obviously have more to say once it's all finished and it's activated. So, you know, it's kind of weird. It's kind of weird to see this light set eventually go, because this set that's currently here has been here since pretty much I was a kid, probably since we've been here. So, you know, it's always kind of strange to see something, you know, that's there for so long to, you know, get replaced. Just kind of a weird feeling, I guess you could say, you know. But anyway, if you remember, there was that light set on Route 454 right there. I told you I thought they were going to replace. Yeah, that one's not being worked on right now. I have a feeling in the near future it will be, but that one's not getting replaced along with these. So I was wrong about that in my original video, if you remember. And just give you an update on that one, too. So, all right, guys, there you go. You know, that's basically all I can say about this for right now. And there will be more info on this once it gets activated. So we shall see you from there. So as usual, guys, thanks a lot for watching, and take care.